Blackstone Audio presents The Place of Dead Roads by William S. Burroughs. This book is read by Ray Porter. To Denton Welch, for Kim Carsons. The original title of this book was The Johnson Family. The Johnson Family was a turn-of-the-century expression to designate good bums and thieves. It was elaborated into a code of conduct. A Johnson honors his obligations. His word is good, and he is a good man to do business with. A Johnson minds his own business. He is not a snoopy, self-righteous, troublemaking person. A Johnson will give help when help is needed. He will not stand by while someone is drowning or trapped under a burning car. The only thing that could unite the planet is a united space program. The Earth becomes a space station and war is simply out. Irrelevant. Flatly insane in a context of research centers, spaceports, and the exhilaration of working with people you like and respect toward an agreed-upon objective. An objective from which all workers will gain. Happiness is a byproduct of function. The planetary space station will give all participants an opportunity to function. 1. Stranger Who Was Passing. Shootout in Boulder. September 17, 1899. What appeared to be an old western shootout took place yesterday afternoon at the Boulder Cemetery. The protagonists have been identified as William Seward Hall, 65, a real estate speculator with holdings in Colorado and New Mexico, and Mike Chase, in his 50s, about whom nothing was known. Hall resided in New York City and wrote Western stories under the pen name of Kim Carsons. He was apparently here on a business trip, a police source stated. At first glance, it appeared that Chase and Hall had killed each other in a shootout, but neither gun had been fired, and both men were killed by single rifle shots fired from a distance. Chase was shot from in front through the chest. Hall was shot in the back. Nobody heard the shots, and police believe the rifleman may have employed a silencer. A hotel key was found in Hall's pocket, and police searched his room at the Overlook Hotel. They found clothing, a .38 revolver, and a book entitled Quién Es by Kim Carsons. Certain passages had been underlined. Police investigating this bizarre occurrence have as yet no clue to the possible motives of the men. Looks like an old grudge of some sort, Police Chief Martin Winters said. When asked whether there was any reason Chase and Hall should want to kill each other, he replied, "Not that I know of, but we are continuing the investigation." The Sunday paper played up the story with pictures of the deceased and the cemetery and diagrams showing the location of the bodies and probable spot from which the shots had been fired. When asked about the make and caliber of the death weapon, the medical examiner stated, "Definitely a rifle. Size of the exit holes is consistent with a .45-70 dum-dum bullet, but the projectiles have not been recovered." The article quoted the underlined passages from Hall's book, Quién Es. Papers in an old attic. An old yellow press clipping from the Manhattan Comet, April 3, 1894. Three members of the Carsons gang were killed today when they attempted to hold up the Manhattan City Bank. A posse dispatched in pursuit of the survivors ran into an ambush and suffered several casualties. Mike Chase, a U.S. Marshal, stated that the ambush was not carried out by the Carsons gang, but by a band of Confederate renegades armed with mortars and grenades. This poem was roted by Kim Carsons after a shootout on Bleecker Street, October 23, 1920. Liverwurst Joe and Cherry Nose Geo, mafia hitmen with Frank the Lip as driver, opened fire on Kim Carsons, Boy Jones, Mars Cleaver, known as Marbles, and Guy Graywood, described as an attorney. In the ensuing exchange of shots, Liverwurst Joe, Cherry Nose Geo, and Frank the Lip was all kilted. Only damage sustained by the Carsons group was to Boy's vest when he took refuge behind a fire hydrant.
"My vest is ruined," he moaned. "And it was dog shit done it. There should be a law."
Owing to certain offensive passages written in the French language, the poem could not be quoted, but an enterprising assistant editor had copies made with translations of the offensive passages and sold them to collectors and curiosity seekers for $5 a copy. Stranger who was passing.
Un grand principe de violence dictait à nos mœurs.
A great principle of violence dictated our fashions. Surely a song for men like a great wind, shaking an iron tree, dead leaves in the winter pissoir.
J'aime ce type vicieux qui ici montre la bite.
I like the vicious types who show the cock here.
Simon, aimes-tu les bruits de pas sur les feuilles mortes?
Simon, do you like the sound of steps on dead leaves? The smell of war and death? Powder smoke back across the mouth blown, powder smoke and brown hair. Death comes with the speed of a million winds. The sheltering sky is thin as paper here. That afternoon when I watched the torn sky bend with the wind, I can see...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.